the CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... I don't know about you, but the mysteries that intrigue me the most are the unexplainable. Stories of a world we cannot fathom, of dimensions invisible, of powers unspeakable, of the sealed book of the devil himself. That, in essence, is what we bring you today. A look into the unknown.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Sergeant Mario of the Roma Police. You are Dr. Adam Parks?
This is preposterous. The police? I haven't done anything.
You will pack your bags and come with me to the police station.
On what charge?
A most serious charge, Dottore. Especially for a visitor.
Look, what are you going to hold me on?
You will be booked, Dottore, as an undesirable alien.
Our mystery drama, The Other Soul, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Gerald Keane and stars Russell Horton and Mandel Kramer. It is sponsored in part by True Value Hardware Stores. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Most of us don't realize is that the past and the present are one. That time, as we know it, hours, days, weeks, years, are man-made divisions. And nowhere in the world is one more reminded of the long passage of man than in the Roman catacombs. 50 years after Christ, the first Christians were buried in those subterranean cemeteries. But even today, well, I'm getting ahead of my story. Let Dr. Lawrence Kane tell it. For he knows it well.
I'm generally called Larry, even by my patients. None of that Dr. Kane stuff for me. I have a partnership with Adam Parks, and when this year's medical conference was to be held in Rome, one of us had to stay behind and take care of the practice. So, Adam went. The last postcard I received from him said, "Today I'm going to visit the catacombs.
Let us all please stay together in these catacombs. I don't want to lose anybody. Follow me, a destra, to the right. These steps are cut into the rock. We are now coming to a gallery. Watch your step. Hold on to the railing.
Excuse me.
Scusi?
How many people would you say are buried in these catacombs?
I'm going to describe, just listen. Everybody stop, please. The first Christians who were buried here had to be in secret. The religion was new and forbidden. These cavities are cut into the rock. They are called loculi.
Sir, are they all the same size?
Please, please, the size of the cavities according to how big the body. Centuries ago, after buried, the cavity closed up, hermetically sealed with brick or marble or slate or stone. Follow me.
I beg your pardon, but I happen to hear you asking the guide many questions about the catacombs. Are you English, sir?
No, I'm an American. I'm very interested in the history of Rome. If you'll excuse me asking you a question, the lady you're with, who's standing right there, she looks very pale to me. I suggest you take her right away up into the air.
Just a moment, sir. This lady wishes to give you something.
Give me something?
Here, take this.
What is it?
Take this card.
Well, where's the gentleman you were just with? I told him, madam, you're very pale. I suggested the air here in the catacombs is not too good for you. You see, I'm a doctor. I can see you're being affected by this stale underground air.
Please.
Where is he, the gentleman? Did he rejoin the tour?
If you value your life, you must take this car.
Oh, yes, sir. Can I help you?
Yes, I'm Dr. Adam Parks. I'm with the doctor's convention.
Oh, yes, yes, doctor. What can I do for you?
Look, someone gave me this card, and I can't read what it says.
You cannot read it?
Well, I was in the catacombs this morning, and a lady gave me this card. You see, I don't speak Italian, so I thought if you wouldn't mind, perhaps you could just tell me.
Oh, of course, of course. Give it to me. It's very fancy, written in red ink. Where did you say you got this card?
Well, from a beautiful lady, a stranger in the catacombs.
That is enough. Don't say any more.
What's the matter?
You must leave this hotel.
What are you talking about?
Dr. Parks, I tell you, as manager of the Continental Hotel, I order you to leave this hotel now. Do not.
Well, I'm not going to. The convention starts this evening. Why should I move to another hotel? What's the matter with you?
The matter is not with me. This is extremely serious. All right. All right. You can go to your convention tonight. But tomorrow morning, at 7 o'clock, I shall send a boy to your room. You will check out of this hotel. If you are not out of here by 8 o'clock, I send for the police.
Who is it?
The manager, Dr. Parks. Are you ready to leave?
What time is it?
It is 7 o'clock sharp. Are you ready to leave?
Hey, look, what is all this nonsense?
I see you are not packed yet. Allow me to introduce Sergeant Mario of the Rome Police. He may be able to persuade you. I leave you, gentlemen.
Dr. Adam Parks, sit down, please. Well,
this is preposterous. I haven't done anything. What is the matter with that man?
May I see the card which you showed him?
Well, certainly. Here. Well? Sergeant Mario, would you mind telling me what is written on there?
I am afraid I cannot.
You cannot? You can't read it? I thought you were Italian.
I was born in Rome, but this is written in Latin. I don't speak Latin. You will get dressed, pack your bag, and I shall take you to the police station.
The police? Oh, on what charge?
Dr. Parks, you will be booked as an undesirable alien.
I demand my rights as an American citizen. Why am I being questioned in this police station? What have I done?
Dr. Parks, please do not get excited. I have my instructions which I must obey. What is your full name?
Dr. Adam Clay Park.
You are a specialist.
Yes, the heart.
Where do you live?
I was at the Continental Hotel until that crazy manager booted me out.
I mean you're American resident.
I live on Long Island.
This is an island in America.
Now, look, what is the point of all this? I came to Rome with 25 other doctors from all over the world. We're here for a convention. I'm going back to America at the end of the week.
If you do not return soon, Dr. Parks, you married?
Yes.
Name of a wife, please.
Elaine.
You have a children?
Yes. No. No children.
What do you mean, yes and no?
We had a baby. It died.
What did it die of?
What business is it of yours? It died, that's all. I don't want to talk about it.
I must insist. What did your baby die of?
It was an accident. The person carrying it had an accident. Now, are you satisfied?
Who do you know in Roma?
Nobody. I don't know any Italian. I know several of the doctors at the convention.
We questioned the guide who took you through the catacombs. He remembered you very clearly. He said you spoke with a man and a woman, but he could not identify them. Who are they?
I haven't the faintest idea. I never saw them before in my life. It was that woman who gave me the darn card with the red ink writing on it that started all this.
I must leave you now. The interrogation is over for the moment.
Wait a minute. What's going to happen to me?
You will be placed in a cell.
In a cell? Now, you listen to me, Sergeant. As an American, I have a right to be represented by my ambassador, and I demand as an American citizen that you get in touch with the American embassy without any delay.
Of course. Certainly. Why not?
Hello?
Elaine?
Who is this? Adam? Where are you, honey?
Oh, I'm at Kennedy Airport, Elaine, back in the good old USA.
Our Kennedy Airport?
Yep, back sooner than I thought.
Oh, you'll hurry home now, do you hear?
Yeah, I'll grab the first limo I can get.
Oh, this is the most marvelous surprise in the whole world. I missed you so, honey. How come you only stayed in Rome 3 days?
I'll tell you all about it when I get home.
Now I've got you all to myself until Monday. I hope you're not planning to go to the office right away.
Well, to tell you the truth, Elaine, I just want to stay home for a while and think things over.
Well, that's the idea, honey. After all, Larry was going to cover for you with your patients while you were away. So, we don't tell him you're back.
Oh, boy, that smells good.
Oh, Adam, this is so nice having you all to myself.
What?
Well, here we are, just you and me at home having a little old tete-a-tete dinner by candlelight prepared by my own hands, just like when we were first married, remember? Adam?
Hmm?
Well, what are you thinking?
Elaine, I've got to tell you something. The reason I'm home so soon is I was kicked out.
Out of the medical profession?
No, darling, out of the country, out of Italy.
But why? Well, what did you do?
Well, it's a mystery to me. I don't know if I'll ever find out. Someone handed me a card. I couldn't read it, and when I asked the hotel manager what it said, he looked at it and ordered me out of the hotel. Then the police came and quizzed me as if I were a criminal.
What did it say on that card?
Well, that's just it. I don't know. Well, you wouldn't be able to read it either. It's in old Italian.
You mean Latin?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I know Latin. I majored in it in college. Let me see it.
No, I don't know, honey.
Adam Fox, I'm not going to let my shrimps get cold, do you hear? Why, you fuss about that silly old thing. Now, you give me that card, and I'll tell you what it says.
But let's forget about it, Elaine. I just assume. All the way home, I had this awful fear growing that those words written on that card may be the handwriting on the wall for me. Something terrifying is going to happen.
Don't say that, Adam. I don't think I could bear another tragedy.
Julius Caesar, like many men of his time, was what one would call today superstitious. Nevertheless, his observations upon the mysterious are worth remembering. We are the most seriously frightened, he wrote, at things which are not seen, which are hidden away and unknown. True, the dagger that stabbed Caesar to death was a hidden dagger. Has fate hidden something from Adam Parks that might spell the same? I shall return shortly with Act Two. Possible for a man in a foreign land to be given a piece of paper with writing on it that already has begun to change his life? And who is the beautiful woman in Rome who insisted he take it? And why is it that no one yet will tell Adam Parks what the words say? He looks across the table at his wife. Does he dare show her the card?
Elaine, can't we just forget the darn card for now?
No, Adam. Now, if something's wrong, that wrong, I want to share it with you. Well, give it to me.
All right. Here.
Well. You monster. You devil.
Well,
I can't believe I've been married to a man for 5 years and never knew him.
Elaine, what are you talking about?
You think I'm going to sit here across the table from... after my eyes have been opened to what you really are.
Elaine, for pity's sake, don't be like all the others who accuse me and don't tell me why. Elaine, where are you going?
And then, Larry, Elaine said to me, our marriage is finished.
Finished, she said, over.
That's incredible, Adam.
And either she gets out of the apartment or I do.
You mean she told you to leave right then and there?
Larry, what am I going to do?
Well, for tonight, you can sleep here. Tomorrow, well, first thing, we'll go to the office and talk this over.
The office? I couldn't see any patients now. I'm all unnerved. This thing's giving me a real bad case of the shakes.
Yes, Dr. Kane speaking.
Is that you, Larry?
Oh, hello, Elaine. Adam's here. You want to speak to him?
I never want to speak to him again as long as I live.
Elaine, isn't that a little bit harsh? He doesn't even know what he's done.
The reason I called you, Larry, was to explain, so you will have heard it from me. I simply couldn't bear to live with that man one moment longer. I can't even speak his name.
Elaine, I don't know what's come over you. I do know that whatever you think Adam has done, it's not his fault.
Larry, you don't know what you're talking about. That man is a monster.
Now listen to me, Elaine. How do you know what you read on that card is the truth?
Think it over, Elaine. Elaine? She hung up. Something horrendous must have been written on that card.
Can I see it?
You won't understand it any more than I do. It's in Latin, written in longhand, in red ink.
Well, I know some Latin. What I don't know, I can look up in the dictionary.
It's crazy. Just crazy. I almost don't want to know.
Well, you can trust me. We've known each other long enough. I'll translate it, and I'll tell you straight, for your own peace of mind.
You're right. If I can't trust you, old boy, who can I trust?
Well, here's my Latin dictionary. Now, let me see that crazy card. I don't need the dictionary anymore.
Well, you know already. You haven't been at it 10 minutes.
It didn't take me any time at all.
Well, does it make sense?
Adam, I wish more than anything in the world that I hadn't seen that card and what it tells me. You have brought me the worst news one man could bring another.
What are you saying?
The betrayal of a friendship. That's what I'm saying.
Larry, you've got to tell me what. What? Why?
So it was you. It's hard to believe. All these years since then, practicing medicine together, sharing an office. And all the time, it was you. I said you could spend the night here, and I'll have to let you. But tomorrow, Adam, take yourself somewhere else. I am not sharing my practice with you.
I am going out of my mind. This can't be happening to me. It can't be. Larry, tell me why.
Not now. I couldn't find the words. It's too late. Too much water has passed under the bridge. All I know is I don't want to see you, Adam, ever again.
Hello, this is Dr. Parks. Could I speak to Dr. Kane?
Yes, Adam, this is Larry.
Larry, I found her.
You found who?
That woman I met in the catacombs in Rome. She's here, Larry. She's in America. I saw her on the street.
Oh, are you sure?
Well, sure I'm sure, unless I've gone crazy. I followed her to a private house on Fifth Avenue, but I can't get in to see her. Well, I've been ringing that bell for 3 days now. No one answers.
Adam, I'm very busy. What is it you want from me?
Well, don't you see? She'll be able to tell me what it's all about.
Don't you know?
Well, I'm beginning to, I think. The mystery is, no one sees the same thing in those words. A hotel manager, the Italian police, Elaine, you, all different people. What does that card make them believe? Now, maybe I can find out from this woman. Hold on, Larry. I'm talking from a phone booth across the street. Someone's coming out of her door. It's the man she was in the catacombs with. I've got to talk to him. I'll call you back. Excuse me. Do you remember me?
Yes, I do.
You do? Oh, that's fine. In the catacombs?
Yes, I remember you very well.
You remember the lady that you were with? She was very pale. I told you to take her out of the catacombs to get some air, and then you went away, and then she came up to me.
My sister.
Your sister? Oh, she gave me a card with writing and red ink on it. She said I had to take it. Now, I've had the most peculiar and terrible trouble since that day. My whole life is turned upside down. Ben, sheer luck, I saw her 3 days ago. I followed her here. Now, will you please, please take me to her now? I've got to see her.
Dr. Parks, will you please take your hands from my coat?
How do you know my name?
Let go of me.
Look, I am going to kill you right here and now if you don't let me into that house. I'm at the end of my rope.
My sister's very ill. All right. Come with me. Gabriella, I found him.
The suffering man?
Yes. He's here.
Madam, what is written on that card? Why did you give it to me? Why not someone else?
It belonged to you. I gave it to you because I wanted you to...
Tell me, you must tell me. That, look at it. The card.
Only you can say... Save yourself.
Please, I beg you, tell me the...
She is no more.
The card. The words are gone. What was written is gone. What am I to do now?
It so happens that I, Larry Kane, was the doctor called in. Fate, coincidence, call it what you will. When I arrived, there was nothing I could do for the dead woman. Upon examination later, she was found to have had a certain damage to the heart valves. She had literally died of a broken heart. The last time I saw Adam, he was leaving that house with a desperate and terrified look. A week later, Carlo, her brother, came to see me.
I came especially, Dr. Kane, to warn you about Dr. Adam Parks. I know you know him. I saw a look pass between you.
That's the irony of it all. That Dr. Parks should be outside your door for 3 days. Dr. Parks is a heart specialist. Had he been admitted to your house even one day earlier, who knows but that your sister might be alive today. How well did you know him?
Too well, and too briefly.
Did you know about that extraordinary card he says was given to him by your sister in Rome? He showed it to me, and what I saw in it gave me the shock of my life.
Dr. Kane, you would do well to forget you ever laid your eyes on that card.
Yes, I never wish to see it again.
More than warn you about the card and Dr. Parks, I cannot do. It is too dangerous. Good day, sir.
Gone by. Adam, in his own practice, alone, did brilliantly. He never remarried. He never saw me, and although he made more money than almost any other doctor in the profession, he also gave more time to the clinics, the poor. He seemed dedicated and driven. Then, one night my telephone rang. There'd been an accident. He had been shot, and he'd asked for me. I went to the hospital and examined him.
Are you Dr. Kane?
Yes, I am. What happened, officer? Tell me, how was he shot?
We shot him.
What? You, the police?
Well, according to witnesses, at 11 p.m. tonight, a woman came out of a doorway and a man leaped upon her to strangle her. We were cruising nearby, heard her cries, got out of the squad car and pursued the accused. He escaped down a dark alley, we lost him, and then we saw him run across the street. My partner and I called to the perpetrator to halt, or we fire. He refused to stop. And we fired.
You shot the wrong man. Dr. Parks is one of the great doctors of the country. He'd never strangle anybody.
Do you think he'll pull through?
I can tell you this. There isn't one single doctor in the entire profession who won't do everything possible to see that Adam Parks recovers.
Good afternoon, Larry.
A man who this morning had a bullet removed from the lining of his heart, I'd say you're mighty chipper.
Now, who in blazes took a shot at me?
You'll never believe it.
When can I get up? What does the chart say?
That is none of your business, old buddy. Dr. Parks, I am your doctor. Now, you behave like a patient for once in your life, and you got a good chance.
You son of a gun. 10 years it's been. It's good to see you again.
Well, I've been following your career, believe it or not. You've done marvelously, Adam. Maybe I did the right thing by you after all, splitting up.
I never wanted to, Larry.
Well, at the time, I couldn't bear to see you. Today, it's all different. Come in.
Dr. Parks, may I come in? How do you do, Dr. Kane?
What's this all about, officer?
The department asked me to come over and explain. Dr. Parks, do you speak Latin?
Latin?
The woman who was being assaulted last night happened to be a teacher. She said her assailant spoke to her in a stream of Latin words.
Well, I can't read it, I can't write it, I can't speak it.
What are you getting at, officer?
My partner and I have retraced our steps where we followed the assailant last night, where we lost him, and where we saw Dr. Parks running. The department is of the opinion the perpetrator must have been another man.
Larry, I've been thinking. It all ties together. You heard what that cop said about Latin. Old Latin and evil. I thought I'd escaped it. I'd had 10 years of peace, but it hasn't let me go.
I'm pulling the shades down, and you are closing your eyes.
Why can't we turn back the clock? Those old days in medical school? Didn't we have a great time?
Yes.
I see on the board where the term paper's got to be handed in by Friday. Got yours ready, Larry? Me? No, I haven't seen it. Well, where did you leave it? Larry, who would take it? You don't hand it in. You don't graduate.
Adam, go to sleep.
Somebody stole that thesis. I always felt terrible about graduating alone. You're not being able to graduate when I did. It took you another 9 months, almost a year. Start all over again. Write a brand new paper. It never showed up. Who would do a thing like that, Larry?
Who indeed would do a thing like that? I suspect Dr. Adam Clay Parks, in some way, is far more responsible than he remembers. It's most unlikely there's an enemy of his we haven't yet met. For by the end of Act Two of Mystery Theater, we have met all the characters. The clues are in. Only the solution remains. For that, I'll be back shortly with Act Three. I think it is very evident there is some supermortal and unknown force at work here. Officially, the police may say they mistook the man who tried to strangle a woman on a dark street, but can we believe they were mistaken? If that man was Adam Parks, he has paid dearly. So much for my comments. Dr. Larry Kane picks up the story.
The following day, I was at the hospital at 6. Adam had taken a turn for the worse. Possibility of pneumonia or a collapsed lung. We had him in intensive care, heavily sedated. Or so we thought.
Gotta tell you something, Larry. Elaine's the only one who knows. Nobody else. We had a baby. Elaine's mother used to come around, play with the baby, take care of it. I was upstairs in my room, writing a paper for a medical journal. Elaine is out buying groceries. She just got back. Her mother is lying at the bottom of the stairs with our baby in her arms. Horrible. She must have fallen down the whole flight. They're dead, both of them.
You didn't have to tell me. I want you to conserve your strength.
Larry, listen. In case I don't pull out of this, you know that card that the woman gave me in the catacombs? It's in my house, in my library, inside my Bible. I couldn't destroy it. Something always stopped me. I figured I'd be safe if I put it in the Bible.
Adam, please.
But don't stop me now, please. You're the only one who understands this terrible influence on my life. You've got to find out. You've got to, Larry. I charge you with that when I'm gone.
What are you talking about, gone?
I am not going to live out the day, Larry. And I know it.
Adam was right. At 1 minute before midnight, Adam's spirit left him. I was very depressed as I let myself into his house, found the Bible and the card. I hadn't the faintest idea how I could find out anything about its malevolent influence. Hello?
Dr. Kane? Dr. Lawrence Kane?
Yes?
I've been calling for an hour.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just got home.
I'm sorry to call you so late, doctor, but I must see you.
Now? Who is this?
My name is Carlo Neruda. You may not remember me, but we met 10 years ago when my sister Gabriella was very ill and passed away.
Oh, yes. Yes, I do remember. What is it?
Dr. Adam Parks is dead, isn't he?
How do you know? Who told you?
No one told me, but I know. Just before midnight, and I thank the Lord for it.
What are you saying? That he is better off dead?
Yes, I am. I must see you immediately, Dr. It's quite urgent.
All right. You know the address?
I have always known it.
Dottore, you may want to know where I first met Adam Parks and when. To explain, I must tell you first about my sister Gabrielle. Gabrielle had always been greatly interested in the occult. All her life, she had been seeking the bridge between the unknown satanic creatures of the night and those of us here and now. We were in Rome. And this night I'm speaking of, we had attended a special performance at the Teatro Adriano. I was driving back to where we lived. Are you all right, Gabriele? You're so quiet.
Carlo? Go slower. No, slower still.
What is it? Why are you putting your hand on your heart? Are you in pain?
Something. Something terrible is happening over there.
Where are you pointing? Across the Tiber?
Yes. Yes, we must cross the river at once. Take the first bridge.
Are you sure?
That's what I say.
The Ponte Cavour, all right?
No. No, turn right into the Via della Scrofa. Slow down. Slow down. Here, we must stop.
At the Borghese Palace?
Hurry. Get out of the car. Carlo, follow me.
It was very late at night. There was no one in the streets. I ran after Gabriel, who seemed drawn down the crooked alleys like by some invisible power.
There he is, Carlo. Stop that man. Pull him away from that woman. Hurry.
In the dark, I could make out the form of a man struggling on the ground with a woman. I pulled him from her, held his arms behind him, twisted up the back of his jacket until he was helpless. Gabriella went to the woman, a poor fruit seller who had been on her way to market when the man had attacked her and tried to strangle her. She got to her feet and ran off. Suddenly, the man went limp into my arms. I carried him back to our car. Look at him. He's an old ruffian. A well-dressed man. Look at his fine hands. What is this? What is he?
He is a Lucifer man. His soul has been infected.
How do you know this?
I have learned it.
Why would a man like this try to kill that woman? He's coming too now. I can't believe it. His face is a good face of a good man.
You haven't seen his real face. Wait till we get home. Sir, what is your name?
What? Oh, where am I?
Don't worry, sir. You are with friends.
Do you know your name?
Adam Clay Parks.
You are English?
No, American.
What are you doing in Rome?
I don't seem to remember. Wait a minute. Yes, I'm attending a medical conference.
So, you are a doctor.
What were you doing tonight near the Borghese Palace?
Well, I don't know that place.
We found you there. You were trying to strangle a woman.
I was what?
Now, please. Not half an hour ago. There is no use pretending you don't remember.
But I don't. I don't remember anything. Strangling what woman?
Don't be angry with him, brother. It is true. He does not remember. It is his other soul.
What magic Gabriella exercised then, I don't know. She stood within inches of this Adam Parks and spoke to him in a language I did not recognize. Then I knew. It was the most ancient of Latin. Her eyes burned into his. Suddenly, over this respectable-looking American doctor came a change I can only describe as aboriginal. He fell to the ground, crawling on all fours, his face distorted as though every single sin of man were written on it.
See, Carlo? There is no doubt. This is a Lucifer man.
Lucifer? You mean the devil, Satan?
It was not always so that Lucifer meant evil. In ancient Latin, Lucifer meant bringer of light, the morning star.
But this animal, groveling under the floor here, you're not saying he's a saintly man.
He is a slave of Satan. See the way he looks at me. It knows I am its master. This creature is centuries old. Get up, demon soul. Stand up on your two real legs. I shall will you now to answer me.
Yes.
Speak now of a later time in your existence. What are you?
A medicine man, doctor.
Remember a time of sin? A place of sin?
House. There are stairs. Older woman has come to see baby. Younger woman leaves house to buy food.
What do you see now?
Older woman is holding baby in her arms at top of stairs.
Who is this woman?
I don't know. I am silently behind her. She is falling downstairs to the bottom.
You push her?
Yes, I pushed her. The power overcame me. It made me...
Are you in the grip of this power now?
I have always felt the power.
Have you used it only for death?
I have used it for pain. The power made me steal papers important to a student and made him pain.
Who was that?
A young man who had written the papers, doctor papers.
What was the last time you caused death?
I never caused death. The power made me...
Demon soul, you will write on this card. You will remember, and every deed of yours will be set forth.
I cannot write.
I keep this pen in red ink. Now, write your sins.
I have never seen what was written on that card, Doctor. Gabriella said to me, the power of those words are such that he who reads them understands the meaning of what is written and suddenly sees the truth of the bearer.
I have that card. I brought it here from Adam's library.
Have you ever looked at the words?
Once. And as you say, when I did, I realized it was Adam who had stolen a thesis of mine years ago when we were in medical school together.
No, not Adam, but his other demon soul.
I understand that now. He had two souls. One centuries old and evil. The other, the soul of the extraordinary man that I knew. Well, then what happened?
Gabriella took the card and restored Adam Parks to his normal state, and we brought him back to his hotel.
He never remembered any of that night?
No. The following day, Gabriella turned to me and said, "The catacombs, we must go there." She knew Adam Parks would be there, and he was. It was in the catacombs Gabriella gave him back the card. And until her dying day, Gabriella never saw Adam Parks again.
What was her idea in returning it to him?
A Lucifer man has two souls. It was Gabriella's hope that Adam Parks might understand what he had written so that his pure soul could deal with its horrible twin. If Adam Parks could win over his Lucifer soul, it would give meaning to all my sister's studies of the occult.
But her theory was only that, a theory.
Alas, he could not read what he had written. Gabriella learned that too late. A demon soul cannot see what is plain to everyone else. He can never know his own degradation.
Unbelievable. The card. What should I do with it?
I shall look. Nothing is written on it. Nothing. The words disappeared when Gabriella died.
Poor Adam. To carry such a burden through life.
Gabriella once said, when that man dies, he may return to this world, and his other soul may be that of a great doctor.
Reincarnation?
No. Continuation.
She may be right. Perhaps that's the secret of all the great people of today. They are two souls. But their other soul is as great as the soul they were born with.
All is possible, and all will be understood when the unknown becomes known.
As Dr. Larry Kane said, unbelievable. Yet, is it? Haven't we all, at one time or another, felt an urge or desire difficult to control? Acted in a way unlike ourselves? He wasn't himself, we say. Are some of us possibly also afflicted with another soul? I shall return shortly with a few less dangerous thoughts. Do you agree with me that often what we don't know makes a far better story than what we do? And this is not an opinion recently discovered. More than 2,000 years ago, the great Greek Socrates said, The mind always fears an evil the more when it is not known. How true that is still. Yet, how tantalizing. Our cast included Russell Horton, Mandel Kramer, Ann Williams, and Jackson Beck. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
And now, a preview of our next tale.
Don't you think God could have let me have a child? Just one child.
Yes. But he didn't.
Oh, my friend. My good friend. My dear one. My sweet one. Take me with you. Look. I'm crying. My tears are falling on your hands. I'm begging you. Let me go with you. Don't make me stay here because I can't bear it. So take me away with you, please.
I can't. Not yet. And you can bear it.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.